Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel. I want to talk about something that's rather unpleasant, but it's necessary. Mice. If you happen to live near fields or near creeks or near rivers, and the weather starts to change, winter comes, the temperature drops, and it starts to get really cold, a lot of times you're going to have mice, field mice, deer mice, whatever, looking for a home, looking for some place to settle, some warm spot to set up their little nest or whatever. And when that happens, you gotta want to be prepared. It happened to me recently, and what I had to do is set up some traps. I want to talk about some of the traps that work and some of the traps that definitely don't work. There's a lot of different options. There's the capture traps that allows you to capture the mice and have them released. But if you're just looking to get rid of them, the kill traps, I can tell you some traps that will definitely work and some traps that will definitely won't work. So in this video, I want to talk about that. Before we get into that, I gotta tell you that if you're gonna store your preps, make sure you're storing them in plastic containers, like really good. I use the 5-gallon buckets and they work pretty well. I haven't had any issues with roaches or ants or any mice or anything like that when I store things with the 5-gallon buckets, because it can actually seal it tight and you don't have to worry about little critters eating their way through to get to the food source. So if you're storing a lot of wheat to be grained up, that's something you might want to take into consideration. If you store things in a lot of cardboard box, like freeze-dried foods and things like that, understand if it's just a cardboard box separating the critters from the food, you may have an issue. So, all right, guys, I'm going to make this really simple. The old-school Victor traps are highly effective. A lot of people say you should use peanut butter, but I don't recommend peanut butter because it's a soft bait, which they can sort of lick away at. They can lick at it. I recommend actually using a double chocolate cookie, which was highly effective. Double chocolate cookie, particularly that Black Forest double chocolate cookie at Walmart. any double chocolate cookie will be highly effective, especially for deer mice. That's what I found. The Decon, this is a spinning trap. As you just sort of twist, this is total crap. Do not buy that. No mouse will go into there. Usually the mice are going to be a lot bigger than the hole because they're supposed to go into here. You're supposed to wind the trap up or put the bait in from the bottom. Then twist it up. It's supposed to go into this little hole. I had much bigger mice than that. They were mice, but I mean, I think the smallest one could have got in there, but I had some big ones. So some healthy sized mice, I will say that. This is the most effective one. This is a Victor trap, but it's a quick kill trap. All you gotta do is just pull it up. You put something into the bait chamber, and as soon as they lift up this, little part right there, comes right down, just like that. Highly effective. The most effective one I've found. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and don't forget the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye. Oh, and don't forget, make sure you place the mouse trap perpendicular to the wall, not parallel. Because if it's parallel, they'll just come above the trap from this angle and might try to eat it that way. It's just more effective to do it perpendicular to the wall.